Hi, I'm Willie with H5 Technology. Welcome to my channel. Thank you for being here, and I appreciate each and every one of you. What we're going to talk about tonight is, UniFi Cloud Key Gen 2, or what is called Gen 2. Now, if you were on the original Cloud Key, you would know that there are actually two revisions of this. This still has the micro USB for charging, and the latest edition of this one has USB-C. This one also has USB-C. So we're gonna talk a little bit about all of the upgrades that are done to this. Well, let's just get right to it. Here you can see the Gen 1, Gen 2 side by side. And here's another shot from down below. And if we take a look at the physical size of these, you can see that the Gen 1 is slightly smaller than the Gen 2. It's made completely out of plastic, the Gen 1 is. The Gen 2 is mostly metal. You can see here where the SD card slots are. And the Ethernet ports, they're both a little different. They both have different power mechanisms. So you can see Gen 2 just slightly bigger, and there's that thing on the bottom that we're going to talk about here in just a minute. So not much of a size difference, but man, a horsepower difference when we get over to those specs. All right, so now this is what the Cloud Key Gen 2 looks like when it's booting up. You can see the little LED screen or LCD screen, and we see the status bar at the bottom. Now, once that status has gone all the way to the right, the unit is booted up. So right now, I might actually be able to get into like the web interface for this, but I may not be able to get into UniFi. So once that status bar is completely loaded, and you can see the LED on top is also flashing, but once this is all the way over to the right, then UniFi itself should be running on the controller. Remember, there's two different ways to manage a Cloud Key. There's the underlying operating system and then the controller itself. And you can see that we now have the IP address, Bluetooth. It says we have an internet connection. We've got our MAC address there, the previous screen, and this screen right there. Talks about the app. Here's the back end where everything plugs in. This is powered over PoE. We'll just slide it around so you can see. Camera doesn't cut away, no tricks here. And once again, we have our status. Now that is a dock connector. And that dock is supposed to be, there's supposed to be a rack mount piece of hardware coming out for this. All right, so before we get into the software and take a look at the Cloud Key, which I have over here powering up, I want to look at the data sheet for the old Cloud Key real quick so we can, you know, see where we were at and then, you know, how this has kind of come full circle here. We scroll down past all the marketing hubbub here, and you can see that the original is a quad core with 2 gigs of RAM and 16 gigs of storage. Now I can tell you the one that I have only has 8 gigs of internal storage. So the 16 gig is upgraded. So if you're getting the white Cloud Key and it's got USB-C on it, then it is this newer version. It's got the quad core, 2 gig of DDR memory, 16 gigs of onboard storage, gigabit, Ethernet port. It is 802.3AF or 48 volt passive, and it also has that 5 volt USB-C. And what else did they say about this? That's it. The marketing material on this version, and I'm sure that there are just a ton of these out there, so they could be had, you know, fairly inexpensively. All right, so here's the site for what we're calling Gen 2, and right away it says SDN controller, multi-site network management. You can see the marketing for this is completely different than the first gen. And look, I don't have to take mine apart. This is what the inside of it looks like. You know, I've got it right here, and you can see that on the screen is what the inside looks like. It's got Bluetooth, so it's got that Bluetooth, so you can set it up via Bluetooth. Now, this says up to 50 devices, which I don't know how they came to that number, but it used to be on the old Cloud Key, would they say three sites and I don't know how many devices and how many clients. It was more than 50. So I'm going to say that if they say 50 devices, let's cap it at 50 devices, but your mileage may vary and you may get more than that. Now, it does, the MSRP is 179. It's got 2 gigs of RAM. It's got an 8-core, each core running at 2 gigahertz ARM processor. It's got 32 gigs of storage. It's got the gigabit port, and it's got the same power requirements as its predecessor. So now the moment you've all been waiting for. Let's hop into this Cloud Key and take a look at this new interface. Okay, so when your Cloud Key comes up, you're going to have two options. You're going to have the SDM, and right here you can see my controller is not running. I just rebooted it, so that part's still working on coming up. Or we can do manage Cloud Key. So let's go into the manage Cloud Key. Now, default username and password would be UBNT, but I already changed it. So we'll log in. You can see right here from the screen, I mean, they've done a fantastic job with this interface. So it tells us our internet's connected, what our gateway is, our DNS, the model, firmware. If we go to system stats, this is a beautiful, beautiful screen. Up here, by the way, we can change our password, change our username. But you can see we've got a 5%, now a 3% CPU load. It says 37 degrees. That must be Celsius. And then over here, we are using 30% of our memory. Down here, you can see we've got 18.11 gigabytes of 18.7 gigabytes available. And we can insert an SD card to be better protected. If we go back to overview, we can see that the SDN that is installed on here, that came on here was the 5.8.30. We can update this to 5.9.29 just by clicking that. We are on the latest firmware. If we click configure, we can change our name, our time zone, network settings. We can manually update. We can power off, reboot, factory reset. So what we'll do is we will just tell it to update. Yes, and now it is going to update the UniFi SDN or the UniFi controller software. SDN is, you know, the UniFi controller itself. So there are a lot of reasons that you would want to go to this. It's got more memory, it's got more processing speed. Now, here's the kicker here. Is that if you have one of these and you if you unplug it, it has a battery built in. I don't know why they're not touting that here, but this has a battery built in and it will gracefully shut down MongoDB so that we don't corrupt our database. And you know, I'll show you a video of pulling the power and what that looks like. All right, so we're going to cut the power here. I'm going to just unplug the Ethernet. Now, this is just simulating a regular power outage, but you're going to see what happens when the Cloud Key loses power. Okay, it knows power's been disconnected from the unit. It gives us a 7-second countdown, and once the countdown has reached zero, the Cloud Key shuts off, thereby saving your controller from corruption. That's it for this video. If you like the video, please give me a thumbs up. Please subscribe. Please comment and share. Please follow me on Twitter and Instagram. If you need IT consulting, you can go to h5llc.com down there. Fill out the contact form. If you know, we do everything from best practices for not only wired networking, but wireless networking, security, voice over IP. We do web development, especially with a concentration in WordPress. So reach out to us if you need anything like that. If we can't help you, we'll get you to someone who can. While you're over at H5 LLC, you can join the newsletter list. If you want to talk to us on Discord, that link is down there below. And if you want to buy any of the gear you see here on the channel, we do have that Amazon store link down there. Once again, I want to thank all of you. Oh, Patreon link is down there. I want to thank my patrons. And of course, they have early access to these videos, and there is patron only content as well. But once again, I want to thank all of you. I really do truly appreciate you, and I'll see you in the next video.